Hi, welcome everybody. Welcome to a new episode of Fresh Jazzy Sounds. Newly released vinyl with a jazzy vibe, all on vinyl of course. First off, The Error of Times. I've not seen this album mentioned very often. It's a kind of in-between album. It has a little bit of everything. I really like it. It has a jazzy vibe to it, a little bit of funkiness. It also grabs back to music released in the 70s. It wants to go a little bit in the free jazz direction, but never really gets there. It's released on Freestyle. This is the label. These are the members of the band. I must honestly say, not really any I recognize, but still the interplay between them is very good. The next album I'm gonna play is by Nicola Conte. He has been releasing albums since, I think, his first one, beginning of the 2000s, or was it maybe the end of the 90s? He has always has his own special way of doing things. He's very stern in that way, but also in a positive way. He's always a master of finding new talent, combining it with his own music. I really like him for that reason. This album is called Nicola Conte Spiritual Galaxy, and the title of the album is I can just not read it. Let Your Light Shine On. The cast on it is really mind-blowing. If you just look on the inside, you can see some of the people playing on it. It has a little bit of incognito, it goes more bossa style, it goes also back to more original sounds, more traditional songs. This one is, for example, sung by Sarah McFarlane with a very special, recognizable voice. But it's typical what you can expect on this album, which makes it really, really a summer album. And it's actually surprising, it's released on MPS. So usually all its albums are released on Schema from Italy. This one, for some reason, he changed to MPS. Pressing is very well, it's actually amazingly well pressed. For the next album, we go up in Europe to the northern part. It's not Scandinavian, it's Estland. The Estrada Orchestra with jazz beats and something additional, which I can't pronounce. This is typically, like you have UK jazz, you have now Estland's funky first jazz type of beats. And they are really making their own sound. And the big inspirator of this is Misha Panfilov. Is that his real? Yeah, Panfilov. He plays bass, guitar, percussion, tape effects. Although there are other members, although I don't know them. Somebody's for the flute, tenor, electric piano, drums. And all these albums from Estland, they have that sharp edge, so they really embrace that hard funkiness in all the sense, but put in their own thing. Pressing is limited. I think this one was something like 500, but if there's a big demand, they always repress it. So don't worry, if you missed out on this one, you want to get it, I'm sure it will get repressed. But here. You can hear much more beats to it. And the albums are more like EPs, so the playing time is around 35-40 minutes. Next is the reissue. And because it's hard to keep up with everything, so I'm missing left and right stuff. And this was a reissue of the album by Hiroshi Sato, Orien, from Japan. You can see the new. So it's from 79 originally, and it has that, I must say, I don't really know how Japanese were definitely influenced by what was going on in the States. So it has its own jazz thing, but some songs have that West Coast, blue-eyed, AOR soul, I don't know, a mismatch of that smooth end of 70s radio-friendly music. But the twist with a little bit of fusion, a little bit of oriental, makes this a very enjoyable album. Next album we go to my home country. Netherlands, we have one famous, I don't know if he's outside of Holland famous, but in Holland, Benjamin Herman. He's been a sax player, he's been in big bands, the New Cool Collective. He's done a lot of albums, and last year he brought out three albums, one more free jazz style, one a little bit freaky, and this, which is a soundtrack to a documentary. And it is a documentary for the Citroën XM. And it's really that smooth what you want to hear from a documentary. As the background, as you see the car driving on little roads, see a little bit on the inside, it's really fitting. But he also gave it that special, as the car is from the 70s or maybe end of 60s, I think 70s. That sound of that period of time, and I love that sound. But he really captured that in a very, very well. So, most of the songs are like this, some are a little bit more funkier, so let me put on this. This is such a nice album to play late at night. Really makes you forget all the trouble of the day that has passed. Next we have a VC classic. I have not shown it before. Main reason for this is that I have played it a lot. Called Mild Life. I didn't get the first pressing. I think I even missed out on the second pressing. This is the third. I don't know how many they have done, because it has become a really popular album, and for good reason. Although I'm still surprised how many new albums are released with jazz funk vibe. I mean, you can call this anything you want, but it is jazz funk. And this is what they made in the 70s. This is what they killed in the 80s, and now 2019, 2018, so much music is released with this kind of music. Although they gave it their own twist and made it, I guess, for some people more interesting, but it's a very nice album, as they deviated a little bit of the fixed path. curious. I think it's now 1.5 years since it has been released. If they will do a follow-up. I've only seen a remix album, but never saw a really new fresh release. The next album is a little bit of a mystery to me. It's by James Creel Thomas. He is part, or it is released by 22A, so that's the famous label now by Theolodius. I have to think about it. I don't know who, what, where this is coming from, who's playing on it. On the back cover it says all tracks performed by James Creel, Thomas and members of Oma Sextet. I don't know who Oma Sextet is. They're dedicated to my family. So that, I thought that was a nice. It thanks also Klaus for the flute, conga percussion, Bassa for the percussion, and Art Thomas for also the percussion and the tambour and the synthesizer. And it has a, I don't know, maybe it's the little bit of mystery, but something attracts me to this album. As you can hear, it's closer to some hip-hop beats. On the other hand, it is like he's playing way past midnight and he's just jamming away. Recorded it and it turned out to be an excellent song. I'm surprised with this one. And I must say, for some reason, I can't really explain, I really like it. Hope you enjoyed also this episode. See you next time in my next video. Thank you for watching.